Now we will continue the part of resources. We began at the previous lecture by the human resources. So we will continue. Human resources are the people living in the country. They are an economic resource. We have two dimensions of humans as an economic resource. We have the quantitative dimension and the qualitative dimension. First, the quantitative dimension, it's the study of population according to the demographic measures. We have measures like number one, the birth rate. Birth rate can calculated by the formula, the number of births in the given years divided by the total population times 1000. Second one is the death rate. Death rate calculated by the formula, the number of deaths in a given year divided by the total population times 1000. The rate of the natural increase is the difference between the birth rate and the death rate measured in percentage. Number four, the external migration. External migration, we calculate the net migration by the difference between the number of people immigrating and the number of people immigrating. The total increase in population is the natural increase, which is the difference between the birth and the death rate, plus the net migration flow. We have examples for calculating this and birth rates. Example one, if at the start of the year it has a population of 10 million, then it experiences 400,000 births, 150,000 deaths, net migration equals zero. Calculate the population at the end of the year, birth rate, death rate. We will begin by the natural increase in numbers. It's the difference between the number of births and the number of deaths. Number of births is 400,000 minus 150,000 equal 250,000. The total increase in population will be the natural increase, which is calculated before, plus the net migration flow. The net migration flow equals zero, so the total increase in population will be equal 250,000. The total population at the end of year will be the population at the beginning, which equal 10 million, plus the total increase in population, which equal 250,000. So the total population at the end of year equal 10,250,000. To calculate the birth rate, we have the number of births divided by the total population times 1000 will be equal 39.02. The death rate, by the same way, the number of deaths divided by the total population times 1000 will be equal 14.6. Another example, suppose that a country has a population of 60 million at the beginning of year 2015. During that year, it experienced 1,500,000 births and 1 million deaths. Number of immigrants was 350,000 and immigrants people was 150,000. Calculate the total increase in population, the birth and the death rate, natural increase rate. We will begin the answer by the natural increase. The natural increase is the difference between the number of births and the number of deaths. Will be equal 500,000. Net migration is the difference between the people immigrant and the people emigrants. Will be equal 200,000. So the total increase in population is the natural increase plus the net migration will be equal to 500,000. Then we will calculate the total population. The total population at the end of the year will be the population at the beginning, 60 million, plus the total increase in population will be equal as a total 60,500,000 people. We can calculate the birth rate and the death rate by the same way in the previous example. The number of births divided by the total population times 1,000. Death rate will be equal the number of deaths divided by the total population times 1,000. Birth rate will be equal 24.6. Death rate equal 16.8. The natural increase rate equals the birth rate minus the death rate divided by 10. So it will be equal 0.79. Now we will continue the indicators to measure the qualitative approach for the human resources. We have a sex structure. It refers to the number of male relative to the number of female in the population. Number six, where we have also age structure. Age structure, we have three categories of age structure. The first is the young people from the age 0 to 14. Second, working age population, it's from age 15 to 64 years. At the last, we have aging population or the old people, which is above 65 years. The working age population, it's from 15 to 64 years, but practically there are children working in the many economic activities. The labor force, including all the people able, willing, and trying to find a job opportunities or seeking for a job. Its size could be affected by many factors like demographic factors, social economic factors, laws, and legislations. The aging population is the people from 64 years and more. Developed countries have more aging population because they have low births and death rates. The dependency ratio is the ratio of young people plus aging population, which represents dependent population divided by the working age population or the labor force. We have also the expectancy life at birth. It's the expected number of years that an individual is supposed to live. Number seven, the total fertility rate. The total fertility rate, it's the average number of children that would be born to a woman through her reproductive years. It refers to the propensity to have children. After measuring the qualitative dimension of the human resources by the previous indicators, we have the relationship between the population and the economy, or how the population number can affect the economy. When we talking about the population and the economy, we have a relationship between the number of people and the resources available. We have two types of problems. There is an overpopulation problem when the number of people exceed the resources available in the country because the people increases in rates or in rates more than the resources or increasing faster than resources, and the amount of resources is inefficient. These countries like Egypt and Brazil. The result will be increasing in consumption, increasing in imports, leading to increase in the public spending. So efforts and policies in these countries are targeted toward decrease the birth rates according to the birth control programs. The another phase or the another type of the problem is the underpopulation problem, when the number of people is less than the resources available, such as the Gulf countries or the Europe countries. It's also a problem because we need more people to can benefit from these resources. More people are needed in order to use these resources. So the policies in these countries aim to increase the birth rates as a consequence of underpopulation. How population structure can affect the economy by two types. Number one is the impact of age structure. The age structure could lead to a negative effects when we have more dependency ratio. The pattern of consumption and the labor mobility will affect by the age structure. When we have more old people or when we have more aging population, we have more negative effects on the economy. The second is the impact of a sex structure. When we have more women, it means a smaller working population, as females are less flexible in their movement between jobs and areas of work. Second, we have the qualitative dimension for the human resources. In the last 30 years, we have a new economic trend. It's about the human resources or investing in human capital. So human development is a process that put the people in the center of development process, enlarging their choices in order to improve their quality of life. Now we are caring about the quality of life, so the development will be development of people, by people and for people. The first step of development or human development is development of people. Development of people refers to improving the quality of people as we consider the people as resources or as factors of production. So the people have become the end of development. This step is called human resource development. Human resource development, as we are looking to the people as a factor of production or as resources. Of course, it differs from the human development. Human resource development differs from human development because human resource development is just the first step of the human development. Human development consists of three steps: of people, by people, and for people. There are three traditional sectors to can invest in the human resources or where the human investment take place to achieve human resource development. These three traditional sectors is education, training, and health care. And note that investing in the physical capital, we have a human capital as a human resources, and we have a physical capital like buildings, like tools, equipments. Investing in this physical capital is important but not sufficient. as we need to invest in the people who will use this capital. Note also that values are not included in these traditional sectors in the human investment, but it's very essential because without values, humans or people will corrupt the society regardless of their level of education, training, and healthcare. People without ethics, people without values will corrupt the society. Second step of the human development is by people. This refers to the effective participation of the qualified people in all aspects of their lives. Note the development by people can't be implemented without the development of people. Then we first development of people, increasing their skills, improve their training according to the previous three traditional sectors. Then we will use these people to make more development or the effective participation of these qualified people. So we must have a qualified people first, then using them in development. The last step is for people. This step refers to improving the quality of life through enlarging people's choices. This shape is a summary for a human development. It has three dimensions of people, which means human resource development. By people, it's the effective participation of people in development process. At the last, we have four people, which means enlarging people choices. Human development of people, or the first step, it can be implemented by three traditional sectors, which is education, training, and healthcare. The second part of resources is the agriculture resources. First, we have the characteristics of agriculture. Agriculture is existed for a thousand of years ago, even since the human being gave up hunting. Land is an important factor in producing agriculture products, unlike any other sectors. In agriculture, differences in soil, climate, or the availability of water will lead to the production of different crops. It's the only sector that produces food, which is related by the food security. Our food security is related to the agriculture resources. Factors affecting agriculture resources. Number one, increase in population. In the absence of reasonable population limits, or when we have high rates of increasing in population, the main challenges of the agriculture resources will be to increase the production of agriculture products. Number two, agriculture land degradation and the water scarcity. Water scarcity may reduce yields by an additional from 5 to 25%. It may be the most powerful crop yield reducers. Number three, energy market impacts on agriculture. Growing demands for energy are additional further pressures on the agriculture system, both to supply traditional bioenergy and to supply industrial bioenergy. The fourth factor from factors that affect agriculture resources is the climate change. The impact of climate change on agriculture resources are basically by three ways. Number one, heat. Over the next 30 to 50 years, the average temperature will be increased by at least 1 degree. CO2, Also, in the next 30 to 50 years, CO2 concentration will increase by about 450 parts per million by volume. The economic consequences for the climate change will be increasing in the prices for the most of important agriculture crops like rice, wheat, maize, and soya beans. This leads to a higher feed and therefore increasing in the prices of meat. As a result of the climate change, we will have a less food security, or will lead to a greater food insecurity. At the last, we have the role of agricultural resources in economic growth. First, it increased food supply. It leads to increase in the net output of the agriculture and consequently increasing in the GDP of the country. If the food supplies increase, its price will decline or will decrease, increasing the effective demand of the output of the other sectors, and consequently its expansion and more job opportunities. Second, will release more labor to industry or to other sectors. Increasing labor productivity in the agriculture sector will enable an absolute decrease in the agriculture employment. It means releasing more workers from agriculture sector to the another sectors like industry. The third one is expansion of agriculture sector. Usually developing countries has a comparative advantage in the agriculture, which could be the main source of exports. Most of exports for the developing countries is agriculture products, which paying the bill of imports for these developing countries from the developed countries.